When you watch the news, do you ever wonder who calls the shots and keeps it all moving smoothly, or sometimes not so smoothly?
Everything can go wrong. A lot of times we'll have a story, a late-breaking story, and it's being edited late, it won't be ready on time, and then we might have to change the format of the show while we're on the air. And that means timing is off. We don't know if the story is going to be ready or not, and so we don't know what's happening. You have to make a decision immediately.
Meet Al Battleman, a man constantly under stress. His job as director of the news show can be compared to the conductor of a symphony orchestra. Everyone associated with the show depends on his direction. Imagine what it's like trying to watch the clock, cue the camera person, follow the script, ask for a tape roll, keep your eye out for a good camera shot, and you'll have some idea of what kind of pressure this man is under. It's literally enough to drive you crazy.
Do you ever get to a point in here that you actually feel like tearing your hair out?
Yes, not too long ago I felt like doing that.
I see you didn't do it.
No, I didn't do it, no. I want to keep this no matter what color it is. As long as it's there, I want to keep it.
The constant pressure of a job like this can and does cause psychological problems for some people.
It can make you chronically anxious. You'll get worried about something specific on your job, like a specific project you're working on now, and that specific tension will grow into a lingering, general, chronic anxiety where you get to worry about everything.
This day, Al's biggest worry is getting the 6 o'clock news together. Directing the show from the control room is just part of his job. Before the show even begins, he must go to the newsroom and check the script the anchors will read for correct times, and must make sure he has slides to go with what they're saying. Sometimes he doesn't get the script as early as he'd like, which makes him pretty nervous because it means he has to rush to put it all together on time. But no matter how many butterflies he has in his stomach, at 6 o'clock, the show must go on.
Fade it out. Completely ready music, ready the mics, cue.
This job requires your undivided attention. There's no other way to remember all you have to do. After 17 years in this crazy business, Al has learned to minimize his stress by not taking it home with him.
I used to, a long time ago. It may have been why I turned gray. But I've taught myself not to carry my problems out of here. I leave them here because once it's happened, it's too late. Worrying about it is not going to change. And every mistake I make, I hope I learn by them.
Diana Morgan, The Daily News.